In this topic, we're going to look at infrastructure monitoring using System Center Operations Manager, or SCOM. So System Center has a lot of things going on with Azure, a lot of ways that can really help you out. So if you've been around for a while, you may have heard of something called MOM in the past, Microsoft Operations Manager, and it's evolved into a larger suite of other things. But one particular part we're going to focus on here is the Operations Manager. I've used Operations Manager with some customers on site, and it's really been extremely helpful because in a lot of services, people will say, what's the best way I should configure this, or what should I look for in all the alerts? Well, guess what? When you have System Center Operations Manager, it actually has templates for all these things. So whether I'm doing DNS or IIS or ADFS or web application proxy, there's always these management packs that exist out there for those things. So likewise, they're taking advantage and leveraging these capabilities within Azure as well. So we have a kind of a big picture here that shows all the various aspects of the System Center Operations Management and how it all works together. So at the center of it all, we have our application, and we have transactions that are happening along with that. So Operations Manager basically is gonna be, you see the green arrows there, that's responsible for monitoring the performance, reliability, and availability of that. Also, and then of course, I'll let Cale talk about the Team Foundation Server, what part that does, but you can also use your Visual Studio Developer Tools along with TFS, or Team Foundation Server, to also do testing with that application as well. And then in the large picture, in the upper left-hand corner, you see there's a global service monitor that kind of is responsible for the bigger part of this picture.
Yeah, and to comment a little bit more on that, this picture. So our application, we're basically just checking things like our healthy state of the application. What's the CPU like on that machine? How much disk space? All this normal telemetry that we need to get back from the app in order to make sure that the app is healthy. And so Operations Manager is one of the key tools that we use to centralize that data. So if we have many applications, it's pretty easy to monitor one or two or even 10 applications. But when you get into enterprise scenarios, where there's thousands of applications, we need to be able to correlate these results and say, well, the application CPU seems to go really high. What happened to the database at that point? And be able to correlate those things together. And Operations Manager is key to bringing all this data together and kind of being able to do these joins to be able to understand what's going on in your environment. On the top left there, we also had the GSM monitoring, which is essentially a probe that we can put out there to basically check the health of an app. So if we had a website running out there on, let's say it's in the East Coast of the US, and let's say we have a user base that tends to hit that from the UK, we can actually see what the experience is from the UK. We can put when we set up that test, we can tell which location we want to kind of ping from, and then we can set up whatever synthetic transactions that we want to have run. So basically, can you log into the application and do you get an HTTP 200 back? And so we can see that kind of, and we can see what response time it was. Did that take 500 milliseconds? Did it take 10 seconds? What is it? And then based on that, we can set up the alerting and some of those things on top of that. Now,
I just want to add one little tip on that too. So just like, you know, everything being latest and greatest too, you want to make sure you have System Center Operations Manager 2012 to be able to utilize GSM.
Yep. Now, one of the things you need to watch out for, though, is when we're using System Center, they're heavily reliant on agents. So if we took a look at a diagram of what we would probably like to set up here in a big infrastructure, typically what's going to happen is a customer is going to already have SCOM installed. So they're going to have their management server over here. And they're going to have new stuff over here that now they want to start monitoring. And this stuff's in Azure. And so we're going to start spinning up VMs and things over here that we want to monitor. These guys need to have agents on them in order to talk back to this guy. So we can deploy the agents through a variety of mechanisms, but let's say we end up getting the agents installed, either local installs or we push them out, those kind of things. But now we have, so let's say we have some VMs out here that we're monitoring and we're getting some data back here. Now, I don't know if you can see any problem here, Mark, but I can see a big problem here right now. If we start having 1,000 VMs up here, what's going to happen to that bandwidth that's coming back on-prem? We're going to have a problem, right? Because there's too much data flowing back
and
forth.
Sounds like we need a gateway of some sort there.
Yes, so that's exactly right. So what we would do in that case is, let's take our VMs out of here for a second, and we would actually get rid of all these lines coming over here. And then in this model, we would basically set up a gateway server, which is exactly what it's called. And then we would have our VMs over here. And I'll just draw one, but we would have many. And we could still have the agent on here. These guys would report into this gateway, and then we can channel that data through one pipe coming through there. So whether that's our site, it's typically our site-to-site VPN tunnel for our hybrid connectivity in order to bring that data back. Now, this looks great, and you mentioned you could probably notice that I had VMs here listed when we were doing these things. But what happens if we want to run PaaS instances over here? So that's a different scenario, right? We can't install stuff on PaaS, right? Well,
so like Azure SQL, for example?
Let's talk about a web role to begin with.
Okay.
So a web role would be over here, and that's in a cloud service, but and there's a VM behind it, we know, but we can't really target it for a deployment of an agent. So what we can do is there's a little piece that we can add to this called a startup task. And that's part of the configuration of the cloud service. So we can configure a startup task, and in our package, remember we have a CS package here, in that package we can put the agent. So we can put the MSI or whatever it is that we need to install in there. Now I'm drawing this out of SCOM, but this will work with third party as well. So if over here this was Splunk, which is a very popular monitoring solution, it works, it's agent based as well. We could actually inject the Splunk agent into that package as well. That will get installed on all the worker roles that are involved. They'll redirect all of their stuff back to a gateway. Now, in Splunk's case, they actually have indexing servers that you can do that with. So they would actually be reporting into there, and then we would do our queries over that or X number of those, however many we had.
Yeah, another point I wanted to bring up about the gateway, too. So you have to think about configuring that gateway. It's, and specifically, so your outbound traffic is allowed, but if you want inbound, you have to configure that specifically.
Yep, definitely. And so this works for one use case, right? So we talked about PaaS here with a worker role, but what about a web app? So a web app, we definitely can't install anything on it. So in a web app model, if we took a look at that, let me clean up the slide here a little bit. In a web app model, obviously we can't install the binaries on it. So we can't run anything over there. But if we have a web app running here, and we'll just say web app here, what we can do is set up Azure Diagnostics. So there's this thing called Azure Diagnostics in the portal when you configure your web app, and we can have that write to blob storage. So down here is Azure Blob Storage. What's cool is both of these that I have mentioned here, SCOM and Splunk, can actually reach across into there and pull data back about that web app. So we can have all of our data running through here, and we can have many of these, and we can have multiple storage accounts over here all getting stuff written to them, and then we'll have this process set up to basically pull from those Azure storage accounts. So in that way, we didn't have to install anything on the web app, and we're still able to get diagnostic information written to blob storage and propagated back to our central repository so we could kind of join that data with everything else, and we have a central place to monitor all of our applications.
So the last part there, can you get back to the picture? On the last part you were talking about, that's where the logs would be, like in the blob?
Yep.
Right, so then we have to keep that secure, right, with a public key infrastructure.
Exactly. So both Splunk and SCOM in this case, and there's others, they have infrastructure built up to allow it, and you put your storage keys in there. Obviously, because these are secured infrastructures, it's okay to use your storage keys, but that's how they work, yeah.
Yep.
And with that, that wraps the topic on infrastructure monitoring using System Center Operations Manager.